Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Ah, what a blessed day we have this morning, and go Chiefs. I just had to get that in there. We're glad you're here with us this morning to worship. It really isn't about the Chiefs. It's about God, and he's going to direct us today to lift up prayer to the Chiefs, right? So anyway, we're glad you're with us here to worship this morning. Raise our voices. Let's raise the roof on this place. Just stand and let's sing our first song, I'll Fly Away. Y'all believe that this morning?
Amen.
Amen indeed. That's going to happen to us all. Now is the time of Days of Elijah. These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sore, still we are the voice in the desert crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, these are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are as wide in the world. Are the laborers in your vineyard declaring the word of the Lord? Behold, he comes riding on a cloud, shining like the sun There's no God like Jehovah, 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 there's no God like Jehovah. Hey, behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet's call. Your voice, it's a year of jubilee, and down on Zion's hill salvation comes. Behold, he comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call. It's your voice, it's a year of jubilee, and down on Zion's hill salvation. Amen. You may be seated. If you didn't believe that, you got to believe this, the ancient words. Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world, they resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words impart words of life, words of hope. Give us strength, help us cope in this world.
Well,
Father God, we come here today knowing that no words were ever truer than the scripture that you've given us to study by. Lives were lost for these words, many lives. And yet we're so free to be here today because of Jesus Christ that we can stand here and give you glory and honor and worship and do it as your body of believers. We're free. We're free from that sin, from that what binds us up on a daily basis, Father. Prayer and repentance. That's what it's all about. Father, we're glad we can be here this morning again to lift you up, to glorify you. And we ask that you guide Brian's words this morning that they might fall on an ear that needs it, that a heart might be touched just at the right time, and that we can lead that person back to you. Because you left the 99 for the one. Father, we just thank you for those opportunities you afford us. Bless us as we continue in this service this morning. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we prepare ourselves for communion time, we're going to sing a communion song. That's what we're going to sing. What's the matter with me? I don't know. Anyway, the men can come forward. Whenever they're prepared, the blood will never lose its power. The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary, the blood that gives me
I've been looking at the many problems that our nation has, and particularly the last couple of weeks, the hate on both sides. Each side says the other side's lying, and it has to be hate, and that's what kind of led me to this thought I have this morning, which is nothing new in our world, I guess. I call it the big hate, the big time of hate. After Jesus was arrested, the Jewish leaders turned him over to Pilate. And Pilate asked, "What charges do you have against this man?" And they merely said, "If he wasn't a criminal, we wouldn't have turned him over to you." And Pilate says, "Well, then, why don't you judge him by your own law?" And these leaders said, "We can't, because we don't have the power to execute him." They had already found him guilty. If we look at John 18, 32, it says, "This took place to fulfill what Jesus had to say about the kind of death he was going to die." It was planned. It was set up. He had to go through it. And God just used hateful men to do it. Pilate went back and asked Jesus, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Is this his own idea? Is this your own idea? Or did others talk to you about me?" John 18, 35 and 6 says, I am a Jew. This is Pilate talking. "I am a Jew," Pilate replied. "Your own people and the chief priest handed you over to me. What is it that you have done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jewish leaders. But now my kingdom is of another place." Jesus' enemies tried to make a case against him. They had men testify that Jesus was a blasphemer. Statements that would give them grounds to execute him. But they found nothing. Some men swore things, and other men swore other things. But their words did not agree. Jesus stood bound with cords around his hands, and the people accused him of many false charges. Finally, the high priest stood up and said to Jesus, "Have you nothing to say? How do you defend yourself against these charges?" Jesus had nothing to say in his defense. Then the high priest asked him, "Are you the Christ, the Son of God?" Jesus said, "I am. And you will see the Son of Man sitting on the right hand of God, coming in a cloud of heaven." Mark 14:62. When the high priest heard this, he was furious. He looked around and exclaimed, "We do not need any witnesses. Did you hear what he said? He claims to be God's son. What should we do?" With one voice, the people yelled, "Crucify him." And they did. They beat him. They spit on him. They nailed him to a cross and poked a hole in his side. Who was it for? You and me. And then God raised him on the third day, and he sits at his right hand to speak in behalf of those who love him. His death and his resurrection was a win-win for you and me. As we partake of these emblems this morning, help us to always remember the death the burial, and the resurrection was for us. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you that you have given us your Son. Oh Lord, in your mighty power, will you instill in each of us that we strive to live the way you would have us live. Help us to acknowledge that on our own we were lost. And because of your great mercy and the blood of Christ, we can come to you. Just forgive us, Father, where we fall short in so many ways, where we don't live up to your standards. But in all your power, Lord, help each of us as we partake of these emblems, that we might never forget why. And Lord, forgive us where we fall short. Strengthen us where we need your strength, that we truly might do and say things that you would be proud of. We just thank you, Lord, for your mercy and your love in the blood of Christ. And it's in his name we pray. Amen.
Let's pray together, shall we? Father God, we thank you so much for that sacrifice that you did give. And it was for us. It was all for us. Because you want a family. You want us to be your strong family of God, encouraging those outside these four walls who come up against the everyday pressures and troubles and problems that grind at their hearts and their minds. And Father, we take up an offering today to do just that, to battle against outside of these walls, to battle those problems. Father, we need this, but you don't need it. All you'd have to say is it would be over and you could end it all. But today, Father, we continue to fight for you. I ask you to bless the gifts and the giver, that strength and wisdom come from these gifts. Let us all be good stewards of your finances. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Decides who writes a symphony.
And all of God's church said, amen indeed. I'm glad he does forgive. Amen. There is no junior church today, but preschool, there is preschool. So they can go down or go in the back if they would, please. There she goes. I think she's leaving the building, Dad. Oh, no, she went the right way. We got it covered. Got it covered. All right, Mr. Bryan, if you would bring our chapter 2 today, we'd appreciate it. Thank you.